Okay, keep going backwards. I've got to do backwards. You ready? 1, 2, 3. This is Asylum letter number 24. During the rest of the day, and much of the night, I have fallen in and out of the feverish slumber full of shapeless phantoms and watery visions, and I know that my miscarriage has left me unwell. I have not known it was coming, but I am not surprised. It happens to one or the other of us girls quite often. We are not fit to sustain life within us. We have barely enough for ourselves. I am glad to have it ended by nature rather than at the hands of a visiting surgeon with rusty tools and careless hands. Some things are so much simpler here than they are in the real world outside. If only everything in life could be narrowed down to two clear and tangible options, with nothing in between to muddy it all up, to be or not to be. As I lie in the black of my thoughts, I hear a sort of creaking, quiet, and very far away. It could be a rat squeaking from within the walls, but it is too repetitive for that. It grows louder, closer, and finally, I recognize it as being the sound of wheels grinding on the gravel drive outside, accompanied by the clicking of hooves. The noise approaches until it seems to be passing just below our window. I rise from my straw to look out and see an open cart being pulled by a happy tall horse. Even the heavy contents of which are covered with a black cloth. The cloth in the entrance hall downstairs strikes 4 morning, but still dark. The moon is shining down upon the courtyard, casting a bright, cold light upon the scene. I watch the cart until it turns the corner of the building and I can see it no more. As the sound of the wheels grows distant, my awareness turns to the frantic muttering coming from the cells around me. Someone begins to shriek, high-pitched and panicked. Veronica raises herself slightly. Ladies, please, she shouts. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. Where was that car going at this hour? I ask. It's a night just like every other night, to a ditch, somewhere in the field behind the asylum. A ditch? Why? What for? But even now, I know. That was the death cart, then. Veronica lay back down at the side. It transports the bodies of the girls who die each day to be buried in the ditch. No, not the ditch. That's wrong. What did she say it was? The pit. Yes. The death pit. I heard it the first time last night when we were out like stone. They shut down the assembly gallery so they brought us here and put into a holding cell, and the girls in the ward hall told me all about it. It's the worst part of being in Ward B, they say. You always think it's going to be someone you know. That night, I thought it might have been you. You had quite a close call there. It comes every night. People die every day. In truth, I have often wondered where they took our dead. I had hoped that the bodies were resting in a churchyard somewhere, hidden away, of course, but buried with some version of dignity. And all this time, the death cart had been making its foolish round. It didn't pass by the side of the asylum house ward A, and so I had never heard it before. From the cell next to Veronica's mind, a girl is sibling. She is repeating the name, Sarah.
Sarah.
Oh, God, Penny, it wasn't even Sarah, says Veronica without raising her head. I saw her myself being led into the royal bedchamber tonight.
She could have died in her cell,
whispers Penny. For the last time, it wasn't Sarah, so please shut it. I'm going home tomorrow, and I need my beauty rest. You're always going home tomorrow, Dee, comes another voice from across the corridor. You've been going home tomorrow for the past 3 years. So why don't you shut it and leave Penny alone? You're not going anywhere. None of us are. Veronica says nothing. She is still. Then turns to face the wall. The ward is quiet again. And I can hear Veronica whispering over and over, as though half asleep. I'm going home. I'm going. And on page 149, you can find my little illustration of the death card. Isn't that lovely? Thank you so much for listening to this story. Thank you so much. This is the key tour because this is the key. This was always the key. And now he finally has it. And now you get to come inside and you get to have it. So, welcome to the asylum. You enjoy your stay because it's much easier to get in than it is to get out. Now, are you ready to party like it's 1841? On the count of three, can I have a yes? One, two, three.
Yeah!
All right, I feel so much better now. I just had to test your volume because who knows how many people are coming. If we only have you, this is all we need. Let's be loud. This is our house.